Welcome, Class 8. Class 8, today I'm going to start with a new chapter, that is reproduction in plants. In this chapter, you are going to study about meaning of reproduction and various modes of reproduction. Basically, there are two modes of reproduction, asexual mode of reproduction and the other one is the sexual mode of reproduction. Children, few plants also follow one more mode of reproduction, and that mode is called as vegetative propagation. So in this chapter, you are going to study in detail about the various modes of reproduction. Now children, let me tell you the things which I'm going to discuss today in this video. In this video, you are going to study about reproduction and about asexual reproduction in detail. So let's start with what is reproduction. Children, reproduction is a process by which an organism increases its number. Now the new organism formed are called as progeny, or we can also call them as offsprings. Now children, the progenies formed are of the same kind of the parents. Now this means that if dogs are performing the process of reproduction, then they are going to produce dogs, and from cats, cats are produced. So children, reproduction is a process by which an organism increases its number and the progenies formed are of the same kind of the parents. Now children, reproduction multiplies the number of individuals of a population. That's what I told you, that it increases the number of individuals and it ensures the continuity of life. Now children, how does reproduction ensures the continuity of life? Or I can also ask that what is the importance of reproduction? Children, you can imagine a condition in which a particular species is unable to reproduce. Now you must be thinking that what is a species? Species are a group of interrelated animals which can reproduce among themselves, or we say it is a group of organisms of similar kind which can reproduce among themselves. Let me give you an example of human beings. Human beings are present throughout the world in various countries. So children, a person living in America or Africa or anywhere is also a human being. Means we all are human beings and we have the capability to reproduce among ourselves. That is what we call as a species. We have the same general characters. We have two eyes, one nose, one mouth. So this is what we say species. So children, I told you that just imagine a condition in which a particular species is unable to reproduce. So if a particular species is unable to reproduce, then that species will not be able to continue on Earth. That entire species will be lost from the Earth. And the term which we use for this is called as extinct, completely lost from the Earth. So that is why reproduction is required. Means if anyone asks you that what is the importance of reproduction, why it should occur, then to maintain the continuity of life, reproduction is required. I hope I am clear now. Now let us move on to the modes of reproduction. As I have told you, basically there are two modes of reproduction, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. But few plants follow one more mode of reproduction, that is called as vegetative reproduction. Now children, let me tell you a few things about sexual reproduction. Let me start from here. Now children, sexual reproduction involves two organisms. Now two organisms means one will be male and the other one will be female. Now these male and female produces sex cells. Like in male, human beings we are talking about, then in males sperms are produced and in female ovum is produced. And as this two sex cells, sperm and ovum, fuse together, they form a structure called as zygote. and this zygote further develops to form an individual. Natural, I am again telling you that in sexual reproduction, two organisms are involved, one male and the other female. Whereas in asexual reproduction, only one organism is involved. Only one organism is sufficient to perform the process of asexual reproduction. But the most important thing in asexual reproduction is that the new organism formed or the progenies formed are exactly the copy of their parents, or we can say they are genetically identical to their parents. Now, why in sexual reproduction the progenies are not entirely identical to their parents? Because there are two organisms involved, so there is a mixing of characters between the male and the female. Therefore, we say that in asexual reproduction, the new organism formed are genetically identical to their parents. Now, children, vegetative reproduction also involved only one organism, or we can say that in vegetative reproduction, the vegetative parts of the plant are involved. Now, let us take a plant, let us take an example here. In this vegetative reproduction, like leaf, root or stem, when these types of parts are involved in increasing the number of the plant, then this type of reproduction is called as vegetative reproduction. Now, children, vegetative reproduction can also be performed naturally as it is performed or artificially. So, natural methods of vegetative reproduction are by root, by underground stem, by aerial stem, by adventitious buds on leaves. Whereas, the artificial methods of vegetative reproduction are by cutting, by layering, by grafting and by tissue culture. Children, don't worry, I will explain each and every method in detail. Now, let us start with asexual mode of reproduction. As I have already told you that in asexual reproduction, only one organism is involved, or we can say only one parent is required, and the organism, or we can say the progeny produced, are genetically identical to their parents. Genetically identical. Now let me explain you genetically identical. Children, everyone of you must have heard about the photocopy machine or Xerox machine. When you want a piece of paper to get photocopied, you get identical copies of that paper. Identical copies of that paper. So children, this is the parent copy and these are the progenies having the exact or same content as it was in the parent's copy. So this is what asexual reproduction is all about. Asexual reproduction says that the progenies produced are exactly identical to their parents. Now children, the mode of reproduction in which a single organism divides and produces two or more individuals. This is asexual reproduction. Now the individuals are genetically identical to the parents and also to each other. And these genetically identical individuals are called as clones. What are they called? They are called as clones. Children, let us study about types of reproduction. There are basically four types of reproduction in your syllabus. The first one is binary fission. Children, fission means breaking of anything. Then the second one is budding. Budding means that a bud forms there. Here, and bud means an outgrowth is formed in the parent cell, and this outgrowth further develops and form a new individual. The third one is the fragmentation, and fragmentation means a particular structure divides into parts, and after the division, each fragment is capable of forming a new individual. The last one is the spore formation or sporulation. So children, in this process, inside the cell, minute spores are formed, minute structures are formed, and when this wall is disrupted, the spores released are capable of forming a new individual. Each spore is capable of forming a new individual. So children, let's start with binary fission. Now, as I have told you, binary fission. Fission means division. So in binary fission, an individual divides into two identical daughter cells because it is a type of asexual reproduction. In this process, first nucleus divides into two, followed by the division of the cell. Now children, this is a bacterial cell. Now before the process of binary fission, the volume of this bacterial cell increases and it has its genetic material here. After the volume increases, this genetic material makes its own copy. So now here you can see the two copies are here. And here it is dividing and forming the second copy. Now children, as the two copies are formed, the wall of the bacterial cell starts invaginating. Now invaginating means, suppose this is a membrane, this is the wall of a bacteria, and it starts moving inward from both the sides. And at one point, these two membranes will meet and the cells will divide. The cell will divide into two. As you can see in this diagram, this is a bacterial cell, and the genetic material of bacterial cell is dividing and forming another one, forming its own copy, and the cell wall is invaginating from both the sides. After that, they separate completely. So children, this was about binary fission. Now binary fission basically occurs in all types of bacteria, though bacteria also follow some other mode of reproduction. So we are not going to study that in this video because that is not in your syllabus. Now many unicellular algae also perform the process of binary fission. Now children, our next type of asexual reproduction is budding. And as I have already told you, that budding means an outgrowth. A bud arises from the parent's body and that bud detaches from the parent's body and form a new individual. So children, in this process, a small bud-like outgrowth develops on the parent. The bud grows, detaches from the parent cell and forms a new individual. You can understand this process by looking at this diagram. This is a mature yeast cell and in this cell a bud is arising. You can see here. Now this outgrowth further develops and the nucleus present in the parent cell starts dividing into two. And then this bud detaches from the parent and forms a new daughter cell. So children, this is about budding. And one more very important thing, that in yeast, sometimes these bud do not get detached from its parent. They remain attached to its surface and forms a chain. You can see it from here. In yeast, a new formed daughter cells do not separate from the parent cell and form a long chain of cells. You can see the diagram here. So children, this is about budding. You can also observe the structure of yeast here. You can look at the chain of the cells. So children, this was all about budding. So in this video, you have studied about meaning of reproduction and why reproduction is important. Another point which you have studied is about asexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, we have discussed about binary fission and budding. Now remaining fragmentation and sporulation will be discussed in the next video. Thank you, children. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.